हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ अवर सेकेंड सेशन ऑफ अवर लेसन अ बाइसिकल इन गुड रिपेयर. इन अ प्रीवियस सेशन वी हैव सीन दैट ऑथर एंड हिज फ्रेंड वेर एक्चुअली मैनेज टू गो फॉर अ लॉन्ग बाइसिकल राइड, बट द बिहेवियर ऑफ ऑथर फ्रेंड इज क्वाइट डिफरेंट. इट ट्रबल्स द ऑथर बिकॉज वेन ही केम, एज यू नो दैट ही केम लेट, एंड वेन ही केम he just tried to repair the bicycle of author, and therefore author was a little bit disturbed. He asked to repair the first wheels of author's bicycle, then gearbox, right? And then let's see what happened at the end of this lesson and in the second part of a lesson. Okay students, so let's start second part of this lesson. He then said that while he was about it, he would see to the chain for me, and at once began talking of the gear case. And after a while, when he opened the total wheel of author's bicycle, then he went towards the gear case, means gear box of the author's cycle. I did try to dissuade him from that. I told him that what an experienced friend of mine once said to me solemnly, if anything goes wrong with your gear case, sell the machine and buy a new one. It comes cheaper. Students, here author's friend asked him to open a gear case, means gear box of that cycle, and then author tried to dissuade them. He tried to refuse him not to do so. No, don't need to open the gear case or a chain kit, right, like that. Then I told him what an experienced friend of mine, and he told that you are so experienced, my friend, but if anything goes wrong with your gearbox, sell the machine and buy new one. It comes cheaper, he said. And author's friend advised him to buy one new machine if gearbox was not working properly. Then look at that next line. He said, people talk like that who understand nothing about machines. Nothing is easier than taking off gear case. Then he replied author that people talk like that who understand nothing about the machine. They people doesn't understand about the machines, okay, but nothing is easier than taking off gear case. And he said that it is so easy to open the gear case. Like that, he replied to the author. I had to confess he was right. In less than 5 minutes, he had the gear case into pieces. And why author confessed he was right? Because in less than 5 minutes, author's friend made the two pieces of gear case and lying on the path and was growling for the screws. And once again, he lied on the path and started for searching the screws. He said it was always a mystery to him the way screws disappeared, and he told author that it was a mystery to find out the screws, okay, because as we know that when we open any kind of instrument, the screws will disappear easily, and it is very hard to find out them again, right? So then look at that next para. Common sense continued to whisper to me, stop him before he does any more mischief. And now of author, means narrator, he was himself thought to himself that he must stop his friend for doing any mischief with his bicycle. You have a right to protect your own property from the ravages of a lunatic. Take him by the scruff of the neck and kick him out of the gate. Here author thought that you have a right to protect your own property. If anybody, any mad person, damages your property, then take him out of your gate. But I'm weak when it comes to hurting other people's feelings, and I let him muddle on. But here author said that I'm so weak because I care about the people's feeling. And if anybody would hurt by my activity or by any kind of my action, then it will be hurt me again. And therefore, Arthur was not able to tell anything to his friend. He gave up looking for the rest of the screws. And then narrator's friend, means author's friend, tried to look out the rest of screws. And he said, screws had a knack of turning up when he least expected them. And that now he would see to the chain. And as he was searching after gearbox, he went toward the chain. He tightened it till it would not move. Means he tightened it so much that it would not move. Next he loosened it until it was twice as loose as it was before. Once, first time he tightened it, then he loosened it, and both the time he was doing unfair work. Then he said, we had better think about getting the front wheel back into its place. And look at that. Then he troubles Arthur more by saying, we will replace the position of wheels, that we should place the first, means front wheel at the back side, and back wheel we will move towards the front side. I held the fork open and he worried with the wheel, and at the end of 10 minutes I suggested he, look at that, how Arthur and his friend were doing the work of repairing of their bicycle. He should hold the fork and that I should handle the wheel, and we changed places. And as said, within a 10 minutes they changed the places of their wheels of cycle. At length we did get the thing into position, and the moment it was in position he burst out laughing. And when they changed position, Arthur's friend start laughing. I said, what's the joke? Arthur asked, what's the joke? He said, well, I am an ass. He compared him with an ass. It was the first thing he had said that made me respect him. See, it is so funny and hilarious for Arthur, because he himself said as an ass, and this thing made the author respect him. I asked him what had led him to discovery. Why you are talking like that? Author asked. Then look at that next line. He said, we have forgotten the balls. Then author's friend replied that he forgotten to put the balls in the bearing. I looked for my hat. It was lying topsy-turvy in the middle of the path. Topsy-turvy means upside down. So that author put all the balls in his hat, and it was lying topsy-turvy, means upside down. He was cheerful disposition. He was of cheerful disposition. He said, well, we must put back all we can find and trust to providence. Then cheerfully he talked like this, that we will put all the balls that we can find out from the remaining balls, and then we start doing that work. Look at that next page. We found 11. How many balls they found? They found 11 balls. We fixed 6 on one side and 5 on the other side, and half an hour later the wheel was in its place again. It need hardly be added that it really did wobble now. Now what happened? When they fixed 6 balls on the one side and 5 on the other side, then that wheel start really wobbling. A child might have noticed it. Means anybody can notice it. He said it would do for the present. And author's friend replied, it is only for some time. Means it is for a present. I said, watching you do this is so real use to me. It is not only your skill that fascinates me. It is your cheery confidence in yourself, your inexplicable hopelessness, hopefulness that does me good. Here, author praises. Knowingly he praises his friend that watching you to do this thing is really helpful, and it your skill to repair the bicycle fascinates me. And what about your confidence? It is so great. I like this. Author praises his friend here. Then, thus encouraged, he set to work to refix the gear case. And after this encouragement by Arthur, his friend set to work to refix the gear case. He stood the bicycle against the house and worked from the outside. Then he stood it against a tree and worked from the onside. So they tried to recover or to repair the bicycle's gear case through many ways. First of all, they stood the bicycle against the house. Then he stood against the tree and worked from the onside. Then I held it for him while he lay on the ground with his head between the wheels and work at it from below and drop oil upon himself. Look at that, how funny things are going on there. Then he took it away from me and doubled himself across it till he lost his balance and slid over on his head. Then Arthur's friend tried to ride the bicycle, and what happened? He suddenly fallen down and slid over on his head. And it is a so funny thing described here by the author. Look at that next para. Then he lost his temper and tried bullying the thing. Then author's friend, as he fallen down, he lost his temper. The bicycle, I was glad to see, showed spirit. And the subsequent proceeding degenerated into the little else than rough and tumble fight between him and the machine. And therefore, then bicycle. Here, author was actually glad to see bicycle spirit, because his friend tried to riding the bicycle, he fallen down, and therefore author was quietly innerly happy. Okay, and therefore then what happened? One moment the bicycle would be on gravel path. Gravel means gravels and sand path, sandy path. One moment the bicycle would be on gravel path and he on top of it. The next, the position would be reverse. He on the gravel path, the bicycle on him. So it is so funny again. And what happened when he again tried to ride the bicycle? He again fallen down and bicycle was on the position of his head like that. And he was below the bicycle. Now he would be standing flush with victory. The bicycle firmly fixed between his legs. But later, again he is standing flushed with a victory, like he got a victory again, and the bicycle firmly fixed within his leg. But his triumph would be short-lived, as he found himself very victorious man. But the triumph of it would be a short for a short life. By a sudden, quick moment, it would be free itself and turning upon him, hit him sharply over the head with one of its handle. While repairing again, when he fixed the bicycle between his legs, again handles turning or had hit him on the head, and therefore he again become annoyed. Look at that last page, how he fallen down. At a quarter to one, dirty and disheveled, cut and bleeding, he said, "I think that will do," and rose to wipe his brow. Then he said that, "I think we have done it," and rose and wipe his brow means he was like a confirmation to repairing of the cycle. Then the bicycle looked as if it also had enough on it, which had received most punishment, it would have been difficult to say. And then bicycle look as if it also had enough of it, then which had received most punishment, and his friend received most punishment, it would have been difficult to say. I took him into the back kitchen where, so far as was possible, he cleaned himself. Then I sent him home. And as his friend felt like that, he repaired the bicycle, but it wasn't actually. Then Arthur took him to his backside of the home, cleaned his friend, and then he sent him to the home. Here our second session ends. This lesson was written by Jeremy K. Jeremy is finished here. It is so funniest thing that he wouldn't be able to, actually he wasn't be able to repair the cycle. Actually there was no need to repair the cycle, but author's friend forcefully do the things. He forcefully opened the wheels and scatter the balls here and there. Then they open the gearbox, or they break the chain, they change the position of wheels. These things are goes continuously, and therefore author was like in trouble. But as the friend was looking for the great repair, he don't have any word to say about him. At last they put the cycle as it is and went home. So this is the story of bicycle in good repair. Students, we will see question and answer in our next sessions. Thank you.